press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello dear students, so let me continue work energy power lecture number 8. So up to part 7 lecture, you know some concepts which are based on work, and I covered some energy. Okay, so we know few formulas related to the work and also energy, and anyhow we know that work and energy both are scalar quantities. Of course next topic also will come, that is power. Okay, that is also a scalar quantity. Okay, see, in the last class we covered some energy, and you know different forms of energies, there are so many forms of energies, but we concentrated on only mechanical energy. So mechanical energy is nothing but potential energy and kinetic energy. Some other forms of energy is also there: heat energy, electrical energy, nuclear energy. Okay, so and some equivalents of energy and mass relation, like Einstein mass energy relation, we can write E is equal to mc square. So from that we can say that mass and energy are interconvertible. Okay, so energy and mass are interconvertible, so we can write energy is equivalent to some other things. Anyhow, this is going to be continue in some other things, means in nuclear physics, some other way. Okay, so we concentrated only kinetic energy and potential energy in the last two sessions. Okay, and see see the next one. I think the last one is potential energy of a spring we covered. Okay, we got potential energy of a spring is U is equals to half K x square. And K, what is K? Force constant, otherwise spring constant. K is nothing but force constant or spring constant. And based on the K, we can decide whether the spring is stiff or weak. Okay, hard or weak. So if K value is more, we say that spring is strong, stiff. If K is less, spring is weak. And we already done, if the block moves from x1 to x2 position, we got some formulas, and I given some 2 or 3 problems in the last sessions. Now let me continue next topic from this chapter, that is, write down the heading. Next one is power. So write down the heading. Next one is power. Okay, so anyhow, the basic definitions you learned in the lower classes. So let me continue again here. Let us continue some extra formulas related to power. Okay, power nothing but, you know, rate of doing work. Okay, or the time rate at which the work is done. Okay, generally we can write the rate of doing work, we can call it as power. So the rate of doing work called as power. Okay, or the time rate at which work is done. The time rate at which work is done also call it as power. The time rate at which work is done also call it as power. Generally power we can represent with P. Power we can represent with P, and if W is the work done in a given time interval is T, then we can write power, or we can write the average power, AVG, average power. So if W is the work done in a given time interval T, if W is the work done in a given time interval T, we can write average power, we can write W by T. So this is the equation of power, equation of power. If W is the work done in a given time interval, some t seconds, we can write average power is W by T. And we can write the unit of power, unit of power is in SI system W nothing but you know it is joule and this is second. Okay, so joule and this is seconds. 1 joule by 1 second we can call it as watt. 1 watt. Okay. Okay. 1 watt. 1 joule by 1 second. Call it as 1 watt. This is in SI system. And in CGS system. So basic things these are erg by second. We can write it as this is also equivalent to 1 watt. Okay, 1 watt. And there is one practical unit for a power. Practical unit of power. Power is HP. Generally, 1 HP we can write it as 746 watt. 1 HP, nothing but horse power. So, this is the practical unit of power, basic things. So, power SI system is joule by second, nothing but watt, or erg per second in CGS system. Otherwise, practical unit of power is HP, horse power. And of course, we can write dimensional formula. Okay, so dimensional formula of power is work by time. What is work? I think you know work is nothing but Fs. F nothing but MA. MAS. M is capital M. A acceleration is LT minus 2 into S means one more L. So I hope that you remember the dimensional formula of work. So ML2 T minus 2 by T. So ML2 T minus 3. Dimensional formula of power is ML2 T minus 3. Okay. So unit of work is written, unit of power also written. Okay. And see, we can write instantaneous power also. Let me write the power at any instant of time, nothing but instantaneous power. So let me write instantaneous power. Instantaneous power. So INST I am writing now. P instant. So if we use some limits, we can write like this. If delta W, delta T are the work done. See, if delta W is the work is done. In a time interval, delta T, then we can write instantaneous power, power at an instant of that instant of time. We can write limit delta T times to 0, we can write delta W by delta T. So, this is the equation of instantaneous power. Or we can write in a differentiation form, we can write like this, instantaneous power, we can write it as dw by dt, dw by dt. Okay. So, let me write one more step, P instantaneous dw. We can write f into d dot, f dot ds, ds is the displacement, dt. What is dw? W is f into dx, w is fx, fs, dw, f into s. So, dw is the scalar product. So, f dot s. So, let us write one more. Known things, these are nothing tough, very easiest things. Instantaneous power, f dot ds by dt. So let me write f is a vector ds bar by dt. What is this ds bar by dt? Tell me now. So ds bar by dt, we can write it as f dot, this is v. So tell me, power also, instantaneous power is defined as the dot product of force vector and velocity vector. So instantaneous power we can define as the dot product of force and velocity, or whenever you will take F dot V, that is nothing but instantaneous power, that is not a average power. There are two names. Okay, generally everyone will use it as a power, but actually two names. One is average power, other one is instantaneous power. Instantaneous power is the dot product of force and velocity. So take this one. So I got instantaneous power, and of course we got average power. Let us link the both, whether they are equal or not, whether some any number will come or not, we will see. So far you know meaning of power, unit, dimensional formulas and basic equations. Okay, nothing, very basic equations. So I am going to extend the some equations about power. Please use all those equations and try to solve the problems from any other textbooks. Okay, so every time I am writing some questions, I think it is taking some time. So let me take some assignment sheets and let me solve the problems. I think that is better instead of writing questions on a board. So let me try some questions in the next sessions. I will give you some assignment sheets, let me solve the problems. Okay, that we will plan in the next sessions. Otherwise, based on the situation or time, I'll write small questions on a board and we will try to solve. Okay, and this is complete, I think. Okay, over. Now see, instantaneous power we got and average power we got. Let me get the relation between these two, instantaneous power and average power. Write down relation between instantaneous power and average power. See, I am extending formulas to solve some problems. A relation between average power and instantaneous power. Only one equation. So instantaneous power and average power. Let us suppose if a body or a car or a bus, whatever may be, body of mass m moving with uniform acceleration a, body of mass m or a car of mass m moving with uniform acceleration a, and after a t interval of time, after t seconds, the body attains a velocity v. If it attains a velocity v, tell me what type of energy possessed by the body. Of course, some work is said to be done by the body. That work done, which is in the form of potential energy. So we can write this body will possess kinetic energy. Okay, kinetic energy. Therefore, here let me write average power. We can write it as work done in this time interval by time, and see average power, very basic equations. This let me write it as half m v square by t. Why? Because body is moving with a speed v, so work done by the body, which is in the form of kinetic energy, half m v square. Okay, and we can write this one as average power p average, which is equivalent to 2, half, let me write here, m into v by t. This v, we can write it as p average is half m by t. V is equal to, let me write at, V is equal to U plus AT. Car starts from rest, body starts from rest. So this V is equal to U plus AT. This is going to be zero. So V, you can write it as AT, because A is the acceleration. It attains some, it is moving with uniform acceleration. T is the time. So,
and one more D is there. V half MA into
V. Okay, T anyhow cancelled out. And this can be written as MA into V. What is this MA? F. MA is F and V by 2. So we can write average power. See, F into V. What is F into V? F dot V. Just now we got it. F dot V. F into V. F and V anyhow vectors. So F into V, which is equivalent to what? F into V, which is equivalent to instantaneous power. So average nothing but 1 by 2. Average power, which is equivalent to instantaneous power by 2. F into V, nothing but instantaneous power. FV, instantaneous power. Average power is F average, P average is equals to 1 by 2 P instant. Okay. And see, okay, write this one. Okay. Now see, for suppose in this case, if the body moving with constant speed, if the body moves with constant velocity, if the body moves with
constant velocity, then what is the acceleration? Zero. If the body moves with
constant velocity, in this situation, average power is balanced by instantaneous power. So keep in mind, if the body moves with a constant speed, then average power, which is equivalent to instantaneous power. If it moves with a uniform acceleration, average power, which is equivalent to instantaneous power by 2, 1 by 2 into instantaneous power. If it moves with a constant speed, both powers are equal. Okay, constant speed means average power is balanced by instantaneous power. Okay, if force is constant, how the power will change? Okay, that also I am going to continue in the continuation now. So average power is balanced by instantaneous power when the body moves with constant velocity. Okay, and see, anyhow we know the unit of power. What is the unit of power? You know already. See, I am extending some steps, maintain some star mark, just you write as like something note, means some extra formulas, those are used to solve basic level of problems. Okay, there are much standard questions about the power. Very simple, power nothing but work by time, remaining we can convert. If work is done in the body in the form of potential energy, we can write W as a mgh. Okay, generally power formula, you have W by T, work by time. If that work, if you identified as a kinetic energy, then you can write half mv square by t. If the work is done in the body, by the body, in the form of something potential energy, that work done you can write mgh by t. Okay, just you change the work. W by t is the formula. W maybe half mv square, maybe mgh. Sometimes maybe body starts with u, gains with v. Means what? Work energy theorem. Half mv square minus half mu square by t. Sometimes height and velocity they will give. Okay, body moving up and with something speed, that also will continue. So you can write W is in two forms, half mv square plus mgh by t. Okay, so based on the given problem, you change the value of W. W may be mgh, maybe half mv square, maybe half m v square minus half m u square, okay, or maybe half m v square plus m g h, okay, based on the given condition you can use, okay. And see one more, anyhow we know the mean,
we know the unit, what is this value? One watt you can take as 1
joule by second, 1 second. That means tell me how to define this watt. The power of an agent is said to be 1 watt, okay, so this is said to be 1 watt. The power of an agent, or the power is said to be, power is said to be 1 watt if 1 joule of work is said to be done, 1 joule of work is done in what? In 1 second. Simple. Power we can, power of an agent, otherwise the power. Power of an agent is said to be 1 watt if 1 joule of work is said to be done in 1 second. In the same manner, we can define watt in another way also. Just you only maintain your words in your notes. 1 watt also we can write it as 1 erg by second. So decide the extension now. So power also, which is equivalent to 1 watt, if 1 erg of work is said to be done in 1 second. 1 erg of work is said to be done in 1 second. Now see, anyhow we know power is equals to work by time. So see the one more point, okay, like you feel that some synopsis or a concepts, okay. So we know power generally work by time. If they given a graph like this, work is varies something with respect to time looks like this. This is the some work is done
in a given time interval for any one body. And if you draw any slope here, no doubt this
slope, y-axis by x-axis, y-axis by x-axis, nothing but what? Power. So keep in mind, the slope of work and time graph gives what? Time graph gives power. Keep in mind, the slope of work and time gives power. The slope of work time graph gives power. And if any graph is given like this, power versus something time, power is done like this, something. If I extend, see what is this region? Tell me the area of this diagram. Area of PT graph gives what? We can identify easily, gives work done. Area of PT, side into side. Area of this one means what? P into T. What is P into T? We know power is equals to W by T. W is equal to P into T. W is equal to P into T. So PT gives what? Keep in mind, what is the PT? Product of power and time gives what? Work done. So area under PT gives work done. Simple things, please keep in mind these simple things. Area under PT curve, PT graph gives work done. Okay, some case at level things. So area under PT curve gives work done, slope of WT graph gives power. Okay. Now see, Anyhow, you know so far, area under FS graph gives, F and S graph gives what? Area under FS graph
gives work done. Area under PT graph also gives work done. Keep in mind, area under PT graph also gives work done.
Completed? See some more formulas. Completed? So anyhow, we know the unit, we know the dimensional formula for the power, and let me extend one more. Sometimes they will give, problem is like this, a machine gun. Machine gun problems generally they will ask in entrances. So a machine gun fires some n bullets per second. A machine gun fires n bullets per second. So just you keep in mind this formula. So they will give gun problem. A machine gun fires n bullets per second. Okay, so that the bullet moves with a speed v, okay, such that the bullet moves with a speed, is v, then to hold the gun means the power required by the gun we need to find out here, power. See, anyhow, the machine gun fires n bullets per second, no doubt each bullet have mass, okay, bullet mass is something m. Now here the power required is work done by time. Work done is no doubt, which is in the form of what? Half mv square
by t. And here I am using for one bullet half mv square by t. Why I am writing work as in the form of kinetic energy means
each bullet is coming out with a speed v, each bullet have some mass m, so half mv square. If it is a one bullet, one half mv square. Two bullets, 2 into half mv square, 3 means 3 into half mv square, n bullets, then what? N half mv square. So basic question. Okay, so this is the power of the machine gun. Okay, they will give this type of questions. Keep in mind, whenever you observe this type of questions, just use this formula to get the answer. No doubt they will give the mass of bullet. Okay, something 100 bullets per second if they give. 100 bullets per second. 100 per second. Second means t is equal to 1. 100, n value 100. Mass if they give 0.1 kg. Okay, speed is something 200 meter per second if they give. Substitute the values, you will get the power. Okay, very basic things. And one more. So one more is they will do like this. See, there is a belt. So this is the some belt arrangement, and some sand is falling on a belt, some sand or whatever, maybe the rice or whatever, maybe. Okay, some they will give the word in the entrance point of view is a gravel. Gravel, otherwise a sand is fall. Okay, so better use regular word.
A sand is dropped
on a conveyor belt. See, this is the conveyor belt. On a conveyor belt, so some sand is dropped on a conveyor belt. Now to move this belt with a constant speed means how much the power is required to move this belt. Okay, so in this case the power required to move the belt, so power required to move the belt, we can write it as to move the belt with a constant speed, to move the belt we can write it as power formula, work by time. Okay, work by time, and this can be written as F into S by T. Okay, or otherwise you can write like this. This is the better way. W, we can write it as d by dt of mv. I think you remember this one. Dp by dt. W is dp by dt. Sorry. F is dp by dt, sorry. F into S by T. What is S? So I am getting dp confusing now. So what is F? F is nothing but dp by dt. Dp by dt, let me write here roughly. Simple things. So this is m into, so mass is varying here. So let me write d by dt of, I can write directly, just I am worried about you only. So F is equals to, we can write V dm by dt. See, this is the F. What is F? V dm by dt. Dm by dt is the variable. What is dm by dt? Rate of mass, sand rate, rate of mass. Something they will give 0.1 kg per second, 0.2 kg per second they will give. And we know power, we can write it as F into V. F nothing but V dm by dt. When conveyor belt problems are given, if any sand is dropped on a conveyor belt, so that the power required to move the belt with a constant speed is P is equal to FV. Okay, constant speed means P is equal to FV. Okay, instantaneous power or average power will be same. So P is equal to FV, but what is F? F you know already from the previous chapter, dP by dT, P nothing but MV, V you write outside because the belt has to move with what? Constant speed. So you write V outside. What is the variable means? Mass is variable. Dm by dt is the mass rate. So dm by dt is the mass rate. Then we got F as V dm by dt. Substitute F as a V dm by dt into V, dm by dt into V square. So this is the power required to move the belt with constant speed. Keep in mind, power required to move the belt with constant speed. Okay, they will give you something, gravel is fall, sand is fall, whatever may be. Okay, they may give sand or gravel. Or a sand is dropped on a conveyor belt. So use this formula to solve this type of question. Some sand is dropping on a belt, to move the belt with a constant speed, then how much the power is needed to move the belt with a constant speed. So this much power is needed to move the belt with a constant speed. Completed. See one more formula. Okay, just you convert work into some other format. Just you identify whether that work is done in the form of potential energy or kinetic energy. If it is potential energy based on the given data, you can write as a mgh. If it is kinetic energy, you can write half m v square. Okay, if mass is not given, you try to convert mass as rho into v. You know mass is equal to rho into v. Why? Because what is rho? Density. Density is equal to mass by volume. If mass is not given in given proper questions, you can convert mass as a some other terms like a volume into density. Okay, see one more formula. They given a motor pump. They given a motor pump that is going to lift the water from a height, from a depth h. Okay, so it is going to lift to the height h, to a height h, so that the water is coming out from the pipe with a rate something dm by dt. something dm by dt. Water come out with a rate is dm by dt. What is dm by dt? Mass per mass rate. Dm by dt is mass rate. Now let us see how to write the power. See, in this situation, power is, pump is lifted the water through a height h. Height is there, so mgh. And after that, water is come out with a speed v. Means what? One more energy. One is a potential energy. Other one is kinetic energy. So in this situation, okay. So let me write like this. If a motor pump lifts water to a height h, okay, so let me write directly now. So delivers means coming out, delivers at a rate of dm by dt with a speed v, then
the power of the motor, pump is, so work by time.
What is this work? What is this work now? Mgh and half m e square. So mgh and half m v square by t. Otherwise, you can write like this. Power, we can write it as m, mass rate is given. Mass rate is given means m by t is given. Okay, dm by dt, otherwise, so you can write like this. So this formula, I am writing in small change. m t, just you can take m outside. So we can write dm by dt, small mass rate, in brackets, gh plus half v square. So this is also not a problem. Instantaneous power, dm by dt. So dm by dt they will give as a 0.1 kg per second, 0.2 kg per second. Okay, you can write m by t also something. If 0.1 kg per second is given, m is 0.1 second, one. gh, h they will give some 3 meter. V they will give. Okay. See how I am extending the formulas, basic formulas. We can use some proportionalities also. So speed up so that I can cover some extra formulas in this session. Okay, so they may give a vehicle is moving along the inclined plane with a force F on a rough inclined plane. Then power required by the engine is power of locomotive. They will give these words, they will give in the entrances, or of course in NCERT also some questions are there. So power, if they ask F minus FK, which is equivalent to resultant force MA, you will get. So if the vehicle is moving up with a force F, F minus, what is opposite there? FK, F minus FK, which is equivalent to MA. Then F, you find it, that F into speed will gives the power. Okay. So those questions are there. Or if the vehicle is moving like this on a road, okay, simple, no need to write. Just if the vehicle is moving on a road with a force F, so that some opposite force is acting, some, if any friction is there, FK, what is the net force? Net force. So net force is FR, which is equivalent to F minus FK. FR is nothing but MA, which is equivalent to F minus FK. So F is equals to MA plus FK. Then if they ask you to find the power, force into velocity. If it moves with a velocity V, constant velocity V, so F into V. What is F? MA plus FK into V. So use these basic things for some other questions. If it is an inclined plane, only FK will changes. Generally FK is mu MG. What is FK? Mu N. N is, you know, along horizontal surface, N is mg. Along inclined plane, N is mg cos theta. Just you change N value. Okay. So if you are interested, you write this one. If a vehicle is moving along a road, and if it is moving along a road with a force F, with a speed V, then power of the engine, we can write F into V, MVA plus FK into V. Okay, let us see one good concept. This is some easy things, leave it. So let us see one good question now. Yeah, see this one carefully. So this is general question. If it is moving up the inclined plane, down the inclined plane, just to decide the FK value, positive or negative, substitute FK value. What is FK? Mu n. What is n? Mg cos theta when it is on inclined plane. If it is on horizontal surface, n is mg. Okay, so this is simple. Let me continue one good concept now. Yeah. see the next concept, important, somewhat good in this session so far. Water which is coming, water is coming out from a hose pipe, otherwise they will give a jet of water coming out from a pipe. Okay, so like this is the pipe, water is coming like this. They will give these words hose pipe, these words they will give in their sentences. That's why I am using some different words. Hose pipe at the rate dm by dt in a time interval t. Water is coming out from a hose pipe of area of cross section A at the rate of dm by dt. Okay. To get the water n times, then tell me how much force is needed, power is needed for that motor. How much force and powers are needed? Okay, how much the force and powers are needed to get the water n times of the previous? So first you try to follow the concept. What they given is, they given water is coming from a hose pipe whose area, let us suppose A, and water is coming with what, right? Dm by dt. Water coming with dm by dt. Okay, coming from a some pipe. This is the pipe, some pump, pipe, whatever. A jet of water, they will give the word, a jet of water coming out from a pipe at the rate of dm by dt. Pipe area of cross section is A. Listen carefully, pipe area of cross section is A. Now what is our target is, we want to increase this. Okay, they use the same pipe, but how much the mass rate has to increase? See, same pipe, water has to come out from dm by dt rate. What this one? N times the water has to increase. As n times has to increase means, what about the speed? Speed, if v is the speed, what is the speed here? V dash, that is equal to how much? Nv. And this is dm dash by dt, which is equivalent to n times of dm by dt. Got the question? From this diagram only we can understand what is we are finding. Actually, water is coming with dm by dt rate, whose pipe area is A, and speed of the water is V. Now, I want to use the same pipe, okay, just I want to change the power of the motor and force required. Okay, how much the force is needed? So, how much the power of the motor is needed? That I want to find. So, to set the motor in n times, how much the power required for that engine? How much the force required for that engine? So, here, initially, see the concept now. So, dm dash by dt. So, to set water n times from the same pipe of area of cross section A, from the same pipe in same time interval, in same time interval is, in the same time interval means, what is the speed? V dash, definitely it has to increase. If the speed of the water is increased, more water will come out. General thing, if the speed of the water will increase, more water will come out from the same pipe whose area of cross section is same. V dash becomes n times of V, and dm dash mass rate. Are you following? What is this dm dash? Mass rate, which is equivalent to n dm by dt. Mass rate is n dm by dt. N dm by dt. Then let us find the force. So let F dash is the new force. Let F dash is the new force. Directly we can write in a matter of three steps. I am extending. F dash is the new force. Then let me write directly. F dash by F. What is F dash? N time. What is F formula? What is F formula? V into dm by dt. V into dm by dt. So F dash, we can write it as V dash dm dash by dt. This is V dm by dt. This dm by dt is starting. This is ending. This is F dash and P dash. Target is to find out what is F dash, what is P dash. So F dash, direct F. V dash is NV. This is N times of dm by dt. V dm by dt. So dm by dt, V dm by dt. So N square. How much
the force required? N square times of the whole force. Here the force is something 2 Newton. Here that should be doubled.
N square times of force is needed. Let us find how much the power. Let P dash is the power required. P dash is the power required. Power required to increase the water for n times rate. Then let me write P dash by P. What is P formula? F into V. F dash V dash. This is FV. P dash by P. What is F dash? F dash is N square V. N square F. V dash is NV. FV. Then how much the power? N cube times. So keep these formulas and concept in mind. So the concept is very simple. Water is coming out of a pipe whose area of cross section is A, so that the mass rate is given dm by dt. Dm by dt water is coming out with a speed V. To set the same water from the same pipe in a same time interval is n times. Then how much the force is needed? N square times force is needed. If the world force is 2 Newton, to get the n times of water, 4 times of force is needed. If the world power is something 3 watt, how much the new power required? 3 cube power required. Okay, so see this concept and practice twice at least. So this is somewhat good today. Speed up. Okay. Yeah. See two more things. So the next one also important. See next concept. A body of mass m starts from rest okay body of mass m starts from rest moves with acceleration moves with acceleration under the constant force, under the constant force, and attains velocity something v naught in a time t naught, then power is. So this is also important for basic level of exams. Body starts from rest, moves with uniform acceleration, and it attains, moves with uniform acceleration means under the constant force f, it attains a velocity v naught in a time t naught. Then they are asking to find how the power is varies. Generally power, instantaneous power, you can write instantaneous power. Once the force is constant, we can write instantaneous power, average power, both are same. Okay, because force is constant, instantaneous power, average power, both are same. This can be written as F into V, this is MA into V. Okay, MA into V. And we can write
F is MA and this velocity. What is this velocity? V is equals to. So from the given question,
V is equal to U plus AT, and this is V naught, starts from rest 0. This is A T naught. What is V naught? A T naught. Then A nothing but V naught by T naught. This A nothing but V naught by T naught. Okay. A nothing but V naught by T naught, and this V we can write it as AT, and P instant we can write P instant, which is directly proportional to the time. This is T naught, this is the time. T naught is the given time. Okay, observe the two times, one is the t naught, other one is small t. What is the t naught, what is small t? Don't confuse here. What is t naught? T naught is the given interval of time. What is this t? Instantaneous time at this instant. Keep in mind small t, which is the instantaneous time. So power proportionals to instantaneous time. Keep in mind power proportional to instantaneous time. This is the time interval given in a question. Small t is the instantaneous time. Small t is the instantaneous time. Keep in mind. Okay. Now let me continue one more in this situation. How the velocity will proportional? How the position will proportional? So write down next thing. Same concept with a small change. So the same concept. Now in this situation, how the velocity is varies.
In this situation, same concept. Body of mass m starts from rest, moves with a acceleration a under constant force. Okay.
Let me write the question again. So a motor, an automobile, or a car of mass m starts from rest under the constant force. Then see, force is constant. What is the power? Power is equals to force into velocity. Force is constant. Then our target is what is the power? Okay, force is constant, so power we need to find in terms of, so target is to find velocity. So I think this is power is constant maybe. So already, sorry, this you change it, constant force already done, sorry for this. Under the constant power, sorry, change it. Car of mass m starts from rest. If power of the engine constant, if power of the engine constant, Then let us see what are the conditions or changes. Power is constant, sorry, already force constant completed. Now the power constant. So P is equal to what? F into V. So power anyhow constant. This can be written as, this is M dV by dt. M dV by dt. Force is M dV by dt. Power is anyhow constant.
So let me write, P, take this M this side, take this dt this side,
equal to V dV. Got it? Simple calculations. Apply the integration. Apply integration on both sides. So integration of P by M dt, which is equivalent to V dV. Limits are 0 to t, 0 to V. P by M you write outside. Dt integration is t. So P by M into t, this is what? V square by 2, something constant. Something constant. Then what is V square? V square is equals to 2pm 2pt by m. Then what is V? V is equal to root of 2pt by m. So V proportionals to root t, V proportional to t to the power of 1 by 2. So this is the answer when motor car is moving with a constant power. V proportionals to, how the velocity of the motor will change? Velocity of the motor proportionals to t to the power of 1 by 2. In the same way, if they ask you to find the displacement, if they ask you to find position, position if they ask, position of that one motor, so position or displacement. Anyhow, we know what is the speed. We got speed as, what is the speed we are getting? V is equals to 2pt by what? M. If they ask you to find the position or displacement, we can write this V as dx by dt, root of 2pt by m. Dx is equals to,
we can write root of 2pt by m dt. Again, apply integration on both sides.
Apply integration on both sides. Here only let me apply. This is x. 2p by m, root 2p by m is outside, integration of root t dt, root t dt, root t nothing but shall I write t to the power of 1 by 2, I think you know integration process, t to the power of 1 by 2, t power 1 by 2, so x is equals to 2p by t, t to the power of 1 by 2 nothing but t to the power of 1 by 2 plus 1 by 1 by 2 plus 1, I hope you remember this formula, x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1. Okay, let me write this left side only. So what is x? Root of 2t by t, this is 3 by 2, let me write 2 by 3, t to the power of 3 by 2. How x is varies? X proportional to, see this is also one of the good question, x proportional to t to the power of, t to the power of 3 by 2. So very simple, just you keep in mind. If a car of mass m starts from rest, okay, if it moves with some constant power, then velocity of the car proportional to t to the power of 1 by 2. Velocity of the car proportional to t to the power of 1 by 2. Position of the car proportional to t to the power of 3 by 2. Displacement of the car proportionals to t to the power of 3 by 2. Velocity proportional to t to the power of 1 by 2. Okay, here car of mass m starts from rest, power of the engine constant, engine supplies some constant power. If the power of the engine constant, then just I am extending some simple mathematics. I think that integration is a trouble for you. Please try to practice at least twice or thrice. Okay, integration, just integration steps only I am using here. See, once if you move, the depth will come. But I am going to stop the depth now. Based on the situation only, I am going to continue now. See, in this session, just started with power, started with very basic level of equation, okay, very basic level of equation, and some formulas I written, so many formulas, use all these formulas and try to solve the problems from any type of textbooks, okay. So power almost completed, work, energy, power, okay, we will enter into the next some some more topic from this chapter, work energy power. Next is something collisions, that we'll enter in the next sessions. So here my request is, please try to practice this integration parts. If you are good in integration, this is nothing for you. If you know the integration formulas, this is nothing. Otherwise, practice at least twice or thrice these things. Okay? Thank you.